Welcome to TradeEasy tutorial. Today we are discussing about day end process in TradeEasy POS software. So let's open the software. This is the login window. Select the company name, username admin, and type the password. Then select the bill series and counter. Here we have three counters, counter 1, 2, and 3. Select the counter. English is selected as default language. You can change the language by clicking on Select Language. The login date and time will be shown here and click on OK. This is the restaurant type POS screen. Before starting the day end process, we have to set the denomination if required. For that, click on page 3, Manage, and then click on Denomination. Denomination is a proper description of a currency amount, usually coins or banknotes. So let's enter the currency amount one by one. Here I am entering the currency of 10 rupees, 20, 100, 500 and 2000. After adding all the currencies, let's save it. Now for day end process, click on page 2, then settings. Here there are several options. For day end process, we have to go to inventory and enable day end process. Also enable the day end total difference for getting the cash difference at the end of the day. Now click on apply for saving the changes you have made. After making the changes, log in again. After selecting the company name, username, counters, there is an extra information available at the bottom of this window. As we enable the day end process, the date and time will be shown where the day is started. And the user who has started the day is also shown here. Now click on OK. The opening cash window is opened. You can directly enter the opening cash of the day or you can select the cash denomination by clicking on denomination button. Enter the cash denomination and continue. Now start entering the sale bill. Enter customer name. You can select the product from the product name column or directly click on the category wise product. The pay mode I'm selecting here is cash. Now pay the bill and click on OK. To print the bill, click on Yes and the print format is shown here. Now let's enter another bill. The pay mode here I am selecting is credit. As the customer is not paying this amount, then select credit and save it. Now I am going to do a payment, that is paying the electricity bill. For that, click on page 4 and then click on payment. Then add the payment, select electricity charges in the DR side and enter the amount. After entering the amount, click on OK. The payment is done via cash and then click on OK. Finally, save the payment. So by this, I'm going to close the day by selecting Exit day end. Now you can enter the closing cash. By the end of the day, how much amount is available can enter here. Or you can also enter the cash denomination by clicking on denomination button. After adding, click on continue to close the day end process. So this is the day end report. The opening cash you have entered will be shown, the total cash sale, cash purchase, cash receipt, cash payment and the sale and purchase returns, everything will be shown here. The total cash at the end of the day will be shown and the difference in cash are also shown here. Today I have entered only one cash sale, one credit sale and one payment. that will be shown in the bottom part. Now, to print this report, you can click on print. This is the print format of day end report. Here, the starting and the ending time will be shown, and the user who have started and entered the billing also will be shown here. The total cash and credit sale is shown. Payment, receipt and other payments are also shown here. The percentage of product sale is also shown here. The opening cash denomination and the closing cash are also shown. The excess and the shortage cash are also showing, and the total tax amount will be shown in the bottom part. Now let's move on to the post screen. For that, open the software. As I am opening via admin user, we can skip the opening cash window. And while opening via another user, the skip window will be inactive. Now for viewing the day end report, select page 4 and click on day end report button. Now select the counter and click on view to view which day report you have to check. The day end report is shown here, which you have previously seen. We also have an option to post the date. Even if the system date is changed after 12 p.m., the software date will not get changed. That is, the date which you have logged in will be there during the transaction. Otherwise, when the system date is getting changed, the transaction date will also get changed. So, to avoid this, we enable the login date in transaction. For that, we went to page 2, settings, button size, then enabling login date in transaction. Click on apply. The changes is applied now. Here, we can see the system date is 1st March and the time is 11:59 p.m. Now let's open the software. Here, the login date and time is same as system date and time. Enter the denomination and open it. So, now let's start billing. Now we can see that the system date is 2nd March, but the software date is still at 1st March. So this was possible only enabling the login date in transaction. So this was all about day end process. Hope you find this video helpful. Thank you.